Hold up now.
So how ugly is Breath of the Wild Wii U going to be? Because it looks way too good on Switch.
It's going to be pretty bad.
You think so?
Well, what's the resolution on Switch? Like, I think the handheld's 480, and then the max output on...
You mean Wii U?
Oh, I'm sorry, yes.
Yeah, yeah, it's like... Yeah.
It's not ideal.
But I need it.
I need it.
I want you to want me.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Nogcast.
I don't know the lyrics.
I don't know. It's not worth remembering right now. That's not a very good song.
Did you start?
Yeah.
Was that oh, hey. We're back.
Finally.
It's March. It is March 2nd. And yeah, we have a very special announcement, folks. I'm pregnant.
So we should just end this episode right now and talk about it, right?
Yeah.
I see.
Nah.
I'm gonna edit like 4 seconds of black there. We invested in a studio, and by a studio I mean spare bedroom, and by spare bedroom I mean I'm renting a room in a friend's apartment and just painting a wall green.
Yeah, but we're gonna have things. We're gonna have a video wall. We're gonna have same difference. We're gonna have parties. We're gonna have cocktail parties. We're gonna have cookouts.
Nope.
All right. Well, this is just not what I signed up for.
I'm gonna have this table.
Mm-hmm.
A green screen wall.
Some posters.
At some point,
we're gonna split the room. We're each gonna get a wall.
So there's three walls, and like one wall is just like all closet.
There's three wall.
Like, okay, so there's four
triangle
walls.
Room.
I just want...
What's that?
Okay. For my girls. Anyway. So, it's basically three walls, and then one... The fourth wall is just a closet, mm-hmm. essentially.
The mirror closet.
Mm. It's going to give us so much room to just stare at ourselves. It's going to be like a dance studio.
Mm-hmm.
In the sense that, like, while we're recording, we're going to stare at ourselves more than we're going to stare at other things. Just be like,
that's weird.
I do look good today.
Can we get the pole that sits there where you like
the bar?
Do the stretch, little leg stretch? I don't know how things work in dance studios.
We could.
You think I go to dance studios?
I mean, we could.
I've been to Zumba.
I like bar. I like ballet.
Bar?
Like
ballet bar.
So like when ballerines would warm up, they would start at the bar and kind of go through their like routine, stretch on it and everything. And then they'd go into the choreography. And like I've done one or two bar classes and it's fun. It really is. It feels like it's like going to yoga.
That was not a knock against ballerinas. That's just a knock against Matthew doing ballerinas. Because I want to see him. I want to see that pirouette. I want to see that twirl. I don't want to see that twirl.
You don't say things.
I'm sorry.
That you're not prepared for.
That's fair. That's fair enough. Because then you just stand up right now and just bust. Everything breaks. This entire thing breaks. But
I could do a triple Lindy.
What is that?
Yeah. Wouldn't you like to know?
I would.
Look up Triple Lindy.
Okay. Not now.
It's from a Rodney Dangerfield movie.
Wait. So yeah. I mean, it's been a hot minute since we've really done anything. Some videos here on the sides. Matthew's been posting some reviews and stuff. But I just want to give kind of an overview of what to expect in the future. When we started Nog, it was Let's Play based primarily. Mm-hmm. We didn't do podcasts. We didn't do this thing.
We tried once, and I don't.
Was that the one at my couch? My guest room.
I still have the audio for it somewhere, and I'm gonna post it eventually.
Oh man, I think it's on SoundCloud.
I have the raw file, so I'm gonna touch it up because we were using the
what did we talk about?
Zelda, cocktails, basically everything we've covered in
already.
Yeah, but like
Zelda cocktails.
It was. We were talking about
like Zelda based cocktails. Or...
No.
Oh, it was the.
It was
the objectively best Zelda game.
Best Zelda game.
Yeah.
Best Zelda game, appropriate drinks and drink locations. Like where does
you don't have whiskey at like a beach bar.
You don't have, like there's something like that. I remember the garbage truck being really interesting because this is when like Vero introduced like the robotic arm.
Oh, we were looking outside the window?
And like I look outside the window and all of a sudden like this truck is just like... It just straight up suplexed the trash can.
Have you seen the ones where it picks up like for the restaurant, the that big ass dumpster?
Mm-hmm.
Those things are crazy. Like if that thing fell down on the driver, that dude's dead. That was good. That was good audio design for that. So. Does it keep doing that?
It does it like two or three times to make sure everything's out.
Well then.
It's a great machine.
Great machine there. But it also killed a bunch of jobs.
Humble Beginnings.
Oh, I thought we were going to talk about waste management some more.
No,
that's okay. Right. From Humble Beginnings. Yeah, so
from,
we started off
from
on...
literally in your bedroom, we went to your living room.
Did we? Oh, yeah.
To home. My bedroom.
Yeah, and now to a different bedroom.
To now to a spare bedroom. That's not
going to have furniture. It's a studio, okay? It's a studio. It's a studio.
I'm going to get a desk. I'm going to get a desk and like maybe like a futon or something. Just...
Oh, can we have a waiting room? I mean, like, with magazines and, like, a TV.
We have a bathroom. We have our own bathroom.
That's not the same.
I mean, people can wait in there. We'll just leave a bunch of magazines.
Just, like, 10 people cramped in the bathroom.
Just leave a bunch of magazines. No, so, okay, so wait. It's three walls, mirror closet, and what we're going to do is we're going to take the furthest wall, or one of the walls, and set up a green screen. I bought green screen paint. I'm going to paint the shit out of it at some point.
We're going to have a montage-style painting thing. I'm going to record
GoPro.
It all.
I'm going to set up the GoPro.
Oh, this is awesome. And then we can put, like, edgy house behind it. Feels like the first time when I met you in the summer.
Did you just make that yourself? It was lovely.
Huh?
Did you make that up yourself? It was lovely.
Yeah. I call it
Summertime?
Dutch Beats. Mm-hmm. Is that actually what the name of the song is?
I don't know. I think so.
When I met you in the summer.
So yeah, you're going to get more of this just on a slightly prettier thing.
It's going to be amazing.
We're gonna have dual cam.
We're not going to have patient saw, though.
We're not going to have patient saw.
That's really upsetting, actually.
It's okay. I should talk, like reach out to her again and see if she'll do another one. I don't want a same saw, but like another piece. Because I haven't checked her website.
Get
in a while.
One for the studio.
Yeah, that would be nice. Yeah. I haven't checked her website, and I don't think she's posted anything recently.
So,
it's Shane Brooking, by the way. Patient saw.
Check it out. Mm-hmm. So besides the podcast, as usual, we're also going to do Twig going forward. And,
yes, we're gonna have to figure that one out. We're not entirely sure if we're gonna have internet there.
Yeah. That'll be a work in progress.
Yeah.
What you can expect in the immediate future is Noncast to continue from episode. This is 11, correct?
10?
No, I think the 2016 in review was 10. I may be wrong though. 10 or 11.
We have our technology.
We have the technology.
We can't rebuild it.
But also on thenoncast.com, a lot of more written pieces coming out. Matthew's been doing some work. And, you know, I've got some stuff in the bank too, but I need to actually put it up.
I don't really want to write a review for Horizon because I'm only 2 hours in. Yeah. And I'm not gonna cover AAA games because that's such an oversaturated thing.
Mm-hmm.
I really want to write about what I want to write about.
Yeah. Your Night in the Woods thing was interesting. That made me want to get it more than I already... I mean, I already wanted to get it.
I feel like it was a little hasty, but...
No, that's... I mean, there's only so much to say about it without spoiling, so...
Yeah, and I didn't want to.
Yeah. But, yeah,
I don't think I've spoiled anything for you yet, have I?
No.
Outside of...
Just like, the minigames and stuff, but... Well.
But, I mean, like, those were in the trailer.
Yeah. So... Expect that. Written stuff coming. I'm going to have 10. Something up by the end of this week. Something very personal to me.
So this is episode this 10 is 10. Of the podcast.
Oh, wow.
The first and only episode 10.
That's true.
Maybe.
Unless we, like, loop. So if we do, like, 100, does it, or, like, 999, does it loop back around?
Yes.
To 0 or 1, though? That's the episode 0.
The couch episode is episode 0. You got to have an episode 0. It wasn't even the couch. It was the like wicker chairs.
Those are comfy. We don't use those enough.
Yeah, they're not.
You hate on my wicker chairs?
They're not like the most comfortable thing. They're more comfortable than what we're sitting on. Which, by the way, I went to Target today. Target has office chairs for $21 that are more comfortable than this, but not by much.
That's a tough call.
I know.
That's a tough call.
I feel like we should just get like memory foam butt pads.
That would greatly improve the seating situation here. Is that what it does? It's not hydraulic, like it doesn't lift you up. Can we have like big spinning chairs that like rotate us up?
Just like the egg chairs?
Yeah. Like but the evil
villain, yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Turning around.
I mean, we can, but...
I'll be petting Olive.
I'm not paying for that.
I will. Or maybe like the barber one that goes up and spins.
Oh, okay.
This has been like the least.
Yeah, we're not doing much.
This is not really a thing.
So I get a wall, you get a wall, we have a video wall.
Can we have like a line in between that designates our space so you don't come to my side?
And I bought painter's tape, we can do that.
Oh, you've gone fucking down. I'm going to build that wall. I don't want to. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. No. Moving on.
You should feel bad for that
one. I do feel bad for that one. Oh, God, I just self-hatred at this moment.
There really isn't much to say. We're just kind of freaking out because we're renting a studio.
Yeah.
We're setting up a studio.
Things are progressing.
I'm going to get acoustic tiles because it's a tile floor, so it's going to be really, like, echoey.
Yeah.
So I got to dampen the sound a little bit, dampen the room a little bit.
Gotcha. So, yeah, if you were concerned that, Nog was dead, if any of our 21 subscribers were like, whoa.
This is poorly framed.
Any of our 21 subscribers were like, hey, whoa, where's my Nog videos? I love them, you know, the kids love the Nog videos.
That's as good as it's gonna get.
They're coming back, folks.
We're back.
Is there like a song that has we're back in it?
Back in black.
That's a long
one. You know I'm going to be
the AC/DC wants their royalties.
From the news.
That was pretty good. You know, my friend saw AC/DC.
That's gonna live in the internet forever.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, there's been much worse things said, I think. Or sung.
Maybe. Probably not.
Yeah.
Not at least for me.
Fair enough. No, so one of my friends went to a AC/DC concert and Slash filled in. For either the lead singer or the guitarist, I can't remember, but yeah, Slash.
It had even the guitar. Okay, so like.
But Slash sings too, right?
No. So last.
Sting sings.
Last year.
Zabadoo dabadoo babadoo, brand new bay.
Last year.
Did you miss Sting?
Angus Young got sick and couldn't tour.
Is he the dude?
He's a guitarist, the schoolboy.
Yeah.
And then Bon Scott had something where, like, if he continued to sing like that, his vocal cords would just, like, snap.
So screaming?
Yes. Yeah, so he was like,
shit.
Maybe not.
Mm. So he switched over to smooth jazz. Back in
I think he black. Just stopped.
Okay. That works too. That works too. So Nintendo Switch launches tonight, but you...
Switch.
Hold up. Switch over to this topic. Switch to Matthew. Switch to Madonna. So, Nintendo Switch launches tonight, but Matthew will not have his tonight because Best Buy does not do midnight releases.
No, Best Buy does midnight releases. Vero doesn't do midnight releases.
Vero Best Buy does not do midnight releases.
And the worst part is, when I called and pre-ordered it, they're like, yeah, we're going to have a midnight release. It's going to be great. I went today to price out some stuff. And
I spent $400 on a genuine cowboy hat just to whoop that ass in 1-2 Switch. And I'm so upset that I cannot...
And we can tomorrow.
No.
All right, fine.
Tonight was the only night I would ever play Switch.
There is never a better time or a worse time.
But no.
Can we? Okay, I want to talk about this week. I want to talk about how fucking hype the past 2 weeks have been. So
there's been a lot of stuff happening.
The past 2 weeks, Night in the Woods, a game that I've been waiting for 3 years, came out.
I didn't know that.
It was Kickstarted 3 years ago. Oh. And like, this was before I had money to Kickstart things, so I was like, I can't.
I'll give you half of my life savings.
I was like I looked at it, like I didn't back it on Kickstarter because I literally couldn't afford to.
Mm-hmm.
But I was so excited like when it got funded because it looked so cool, and I played this way down the line after this, Lost Constellation and Longest Night, which were their proof of concepts, and like fell in love.
Wait, Longest Night was no, I'm thinking of Dolly. Okay, what was Longest Night then?
Longest Night was, it was a proof of concept by the. Team behind Night in the Woods.
Mm-hmm.
And it basically, Lost Constellation is like the setup for everything, like you're dreaming about being with your friends and like reminiscing about things, but then you realize like all of those things are based in like not necessarily false memories, but like myth and lore, and it's not real, and you kind of like wake up from this dream.
Mm-hmm.
And then Longest Night is you're playing through one of those myths.
Oh.
So you're playing as, I think the character's name is Adina or something like that. And she is like, she's the hero of this journey that becomes the myth that's told in Night in the Woods.
Okay, that is crazy use of proof of concept. It's like, I've never heard of anything like that.
It's free on their website, first of all. Mm-hmm. And it's absolutely fascinating. The way that Scott Benson animates is fantastic. It's so unique.
Is he the lead? And, he's the lead guy.
It's three people. It's Scott Benson, who I was familiar with because of his animation.
Wait, so is he the lead on Night in the Woods
as well? There's three leads. Oh, okay. It's Scott Benson, Alex something, and then...
Baldwin?
No, I can't remember the girl's name. There's one of the writers. But they all participate in the writing. Scott Benson, the animation, and Alex something. I remember, like, it's Alex at Winnipeg on Twitter. But that's like,
Alex at Winnipeg on
Twitter? No, but that's the problem. Like, it's thrown me off. Because, like, now I don't think of remember... Actual name. Yeah, I don't remember the name because I always see Alex at Winnipeg.
I mean, you don't call me the Pribnow box, so...
But no, like, it still says Dan C.
Yeah, right, true.
I lost my train of thought. No, Night in the Woods came out after 3 years of, like, really just being excited for it. Go play Lost Constellation and...
Is the other one free, too?
Yeah, both of them are. Longest Night and Lost Constellation are both free on the website. I believe they're only Windows at the moment. Or maybe they're not. I don't remember.
So,
but they're definitely worth playing. They're only PC, however.
Okay. Oh, I want a PC. Hey.
You have a PC now.
I do have a PC now. I'm back to the Master Race, folks. PS4 is dead. Okay. PS4 is dead.
We can have both.
No. Only one. I'm breaking my PS4 tonight now.
Night in the Woods.
I am it's downloading as we speak.
Good.
But.
It's like surprisingly long.
So here's what I want to say, though. I want you to prep me, because I've heard about your boy Greg, G-R-E-G-G.
Mm-hmm.
Is there anyone else that I should be on the lookout for? That I'm, and like, who is the character that you think I would like the most? Like, don't spoil things, but you know, who should I be on the lookout for to be like, that guy?
Like, my favorite character was B.
Is that the protagonist?
So
what's the protagonist's name?
May. My favorite character was B because she was a character that, like, you didn't control.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas, like May is obviously an avatar for you. So, like, May, I love May. I, like, the way that they wrote her character and the way that they wrote, like, the dialogue trees for her are exceptionally natural and exceptionally well done. And it really, it really hit a chord with me.
Yeah.
Like, in a way that...
It's a story about coming home. Is it after college or dropping out of college?
Dropping out of college. So, you drop out of college your sophomore year, you come home.
Sounds familiar to...
I mean, I dropped out... senior year, so
same. Well, not really, but I mean, I'm junior back year? I don't junior know that's just, yeah, I mean, yeah, yeah, no,
well,
so this
you didn't
is
drop out, you just took a break.
Yeah,
you're
still technically
I
but
like,
but
I
no
like,
this is very relatable to our situation, so
it's very close to home.
I'm kind of scared to get like just torn apart by this, like if some serious like stuff goes down.
I don't know how to explain it. Like, it's
Does it make you
it's
feel warm?
Not...
Does it make you feel warm? Like home?
At
that
times.
Home feeling. Okay. But then does it also crush you?
No, it's a really good balance. Because it's not like gone home in the sense that like it just gets progressively sadder and sadder before like culminating in this like realization.
I don't think Gone Home was that sad.
It seems sad. Well, I haven't played it in a while, but I remember it being very sad.
There's also moments of like brevity though when you go through and she's talking about Street Fighter and stuff. Like,
yeah, all
so,
right.
Yeah. But,
sorry,
you know,
that's a poor comparison. And
I mean,
you've seen comparisons all over to all like the stereotypical narrative games.
Okay.
So people have been comparing it to Firewatch. People have been comparing it to Virginia, et cetera, et cetera.
Dear Esther.
It's nothing like those games at all, because it isn't a walking simulator. It's a narrative game by way of platformer, by way of minigame, by way of all these things. So like it tells the narrative in certain parts, but then it shows the narrative in other parts, and it has this great balance between heavy and light, like dark
that's
and bright.
Perfect. Yeah, no, you so, described it as the best narrative game you've ever played.
Easily.
Okay, I'm in.
I did the story itself, like I've said 3 or 4 times, like I relate to it and it spoke to me. So like there was something like there was a little extra there for it, mm-hmm. but the way it's written, and I'm on my second playthrough of it right now because I want to see the other storylines the ones that I missed. None of my choices felt arbitrary.
They all had meaningful, not all, but
I don't know how to explain. You
could do a dialogue response in Firewatch, like, and it wouldn't feel
like Telltale Games. Telltale Games, like mm-hmm. the responses are what you want to say, and it affects the story as you go along. But like with Batman, like you're saying, mm-hmm. like the only difference is like Harvey shows up in the scene as opposed to Selina.
Right.
Like there isn't a real difference. There's just an aesthetic difference. Mm-hmm. Whereas something in this, your choices actively affect what storyline you're going to come from. So it branches.
The world shapes around you.
It very much branches, but it doesn't really come back together.
Okay.
So like the main arc.
So it's opposite of Firewatch. Spoilers for Firewatch. Everything. And it starts at one point, yeah. wraps, and everything comes back in a neat little bow, like an onion shape.
And it's not like you get different endings.
Like an onion shape?
Like it's a not lemon? Like you get different endings, but the way you get to those endings is totally different, and the way you get to the ending affects how the ending is perceived.
Okay, I'm just going to have to get through it and then get back to you on that
it's
one.
It's hard to explain.
Yeah, but that sounds fascinating, because that's definitely a big problem. In the Batman one, that example, like, how do I put this? So Selina or Harvey will be in that scenario, but then, you know, they also have those things where you'll like say something to Harvey and it'll be like, Harvey will remember that. But then
it's just one of those awkward animation switches. It's like,
yeah, yeah. The Telltale stuff. But
I'm not a fan. I really am not.
That we'll save your Telltale hate for another day.
It's not hate. It's just ambivalence. It's there. I'm not going to play it. It's
fair
fine.
Enough. No, but then, so that makes the other dialogue choices feel less important, because the ones that don't say, Harvey will remember that, makes you just feel like, okay, like,
cool.
I could have literally said any of the things.
Yeah, because he's going to remember all of them.
Right. Well, no, I mean, like, so...
No, I know what you're saying. I'm just being a dick about it.
Ah. All right, we'll see you later.
So Night in the Woods came out, played the ever-living crap out of that. I haven't slept too much this past 2 weeks. Horizon Zero Dawn came out.
Yeah, I had a choice to make. Good. I could either go all in and just get Horizon and just become the Dino Hunter. I know it's really good. Everyone's just gonna. Or I could just wait for Zelda because I need an open world thing.
The problem I was having was I was playing Rise of the Tomb Raider. I was playing Rise of the Tomb Raider before Night in the Woods, mm-hmm. and then I went from Rise of the Tomb Raider, Night in the Woods, straight to Horizon. And, like, after playing...
But Rise isn't open world.
It's close.
Okay.
Like,
Because the original wasn't.
It's not open world. It's just a very big environment.
Okay.
And it's not like, look at that mountain over there. You can go to that mountain. It's like, the story
will... You will get to
the story
mountain,
will
yeah.
guide me to the mountain. Mm-hmm. But, like, I can explore the plains. Whereas, like, Horizon Zero Dawn is, like, I can just take off. If
right,
I wanted
right.
to. And I'm only about 4 hours into Horizon, and... It's got not a learning curve. It has those stupid tutorials that I hate.
See, okay, I heard that the tutorials were handled really, really well. I was listening to IGN Gamescoop today, and they were talking about it. It was a past episode, but they were talking about it, and they were saying that a listener wrote in. I'm rusty, you know. It's been 2 months. A listener wrote in and said, hey, like, what happened? I haven't played games in 15 years. What happened to the inserts, the little tutorial inserts? Mm-hmm. And they're like, oh, you have been gone for a while. No one does that anymore.
Yeah, no, it's stupid.
But so they were saying that now it's baked into the game. So, and they brought up Horizon and how it handles, and I don't know what it is, so I want you to speak to it. But they said it handles the introduction of the systems very, very well.
From what I have seen so far, it hasn't done anything new.
Okay.
In tutorial wise.
Sure.
Mechanic wise.
It's like a branch. Press X to jump or whatever.
Yeah, it's very much like. It has the on screen pop ups, which I always hate. Mm-hmm. Like, use R3 right here.
Or it's like a wall of text.
It's always.
Aloy can use.
Yeah. So, like so far, like every time I pull up a weapon and if I go to draw something, it'll have the prompt press L2 to.
Ooh.
To cancel.
Okay.
And I'm like, I know that.
That goes away.
It doesn't
can
go away.
Can you turn it? Oh.
I put on the dynamic HUD,
mm-hmm.
So, like, when I'm not using something in particular, like...
Oh, it turns it all off?
Yeah.
Oh, that's the best.
So, like, if I get... So, it's all the pieces on the thing. So, if I get hit, the damage will pop up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But once I heal or once I get out of that situation, it'll die off.
Once I realized that you could do that in Dark Souls 3, mm-hmm. immediately. Because everything's so beautiful, but, the, you know, the... I mean, the HUD's not... It's, yeah, not, yeah. it's not an intrusive HUD, but, like, seeing... Like, just being the character, that's mm-hmm. it. It's so good. That's...
I was always a fan of HUDless displays.
HUDless.
Because, like, Last of Us, I turn it off.
On grounded mode, yeah.
Yeah.
That is a lot better. I got my ass kicked, though, by the I stopped at the bloater.
Did you really?
I stopped so hard at the bloater. I was having a tough time with that.
It's one of those things that you just have to keep kiting it. It's...
Yeah.
Like...
But grounded, so everything goes
grounded
well.
Grounded mode's really good, but the AI is just so exploitable.
That's fair. But you need it. You
yeah.
know, that's the thing with Dark Souls as well. It's... The AI is exploitable, and if you don't, then you're either just a god or you just die.
Yeah.
Like, you know, so... There's workarounds. Back to the Switch, though. Switch.
So just hype week. Night in the Woods,
oh, yeah, yeah.
to Studio, to Horizon Zero Dawn, mm-hmm. to Logan tonight.
Yes. I think
Old Man Logan.
I think I'm doing
so
that.
So excited. Yes, you're going to that.
I think I'm doing that.
We're all going to it.
I think I'm doing that. No, I might have something with the folks. No, we're going to that.
We're going to that. We're going to that.
We're going to Logan.
We're going to Logan.
I liked your line yesterday. She's like three.
Yeah, that was...
We were talking about X-23, and yeah. that was... Yeah, no.
And
so, wait.
Nintendo Switch.
Super Hype Week ends... Oh, yeah, Switch is the end cap to that, right?
Batman.
Super Hype...
Oh, Lego Batman. I saw Lego Batman. That was actually really good. Yeah, it's actually really good.
Okay, I've heard that the Lego movie was also really good.
Yes.
I like
the animation a lot.
That's cool. It's just weird that Lego makes movies now, but cool. More power to them. I mean, it's an unstoppable franchise machine, so... Especially with the games.
Oh, yeah.
Darn, what was I going to say?
This week.
Switch. Switch.
Did that help?
No.
Okay.
That's not... It was not Switch, but... so what's...
Logan?
That's what it is. This Sunday, I am hosting
Sunday.
Marvel vs. Capcom 3 tournament, because we had to rain check it from the last time. But right. I'm just so excited.
You work Sunday.
No, I don't. Tom Walsh...
No.
I'm not. Oh.
You're on Sunday.
What?
Yeah, 3:30.
Okay, well then, I'm not hosting the Marvel vs. Capcom.
Do it Monday.
God damn it. Yeah, but everyone else in it is like adults, so they have things, yeah.
Sorry.
They said it wasn't working Sundays. I mean, I'm not unhappy, but...
I'm like 90% sure you're scheduled for Sunday.
So my friends are going to have a Marvel's Capcom 3 tournament, and I'll just play the winner afterwards. I guess that's how that works.
It's like Mortal Kombat. It's not really a tournament. It's just like a bracket that you kind of... Or ladder.
It's like
climb.
Six people, so yeah.
And you're Shao Kahn.
I am Shao Kahn. Spam. No, so... but the reason I bring this up is that... I just forgot how good that game is. I forgot how much fun.
It's a very good game. I'm very bad at fighting games, but it's a very good game.
And the reason I also bring this up is that 2017 has been the year of fighting games for me. Street Fighter V just released a new character, Russian chick,
mm-hmm.
Colleen. And, like, yeah. I don't know. It's just been interesting because I've never really cared about fighting games, and now suddenly I'm in.
Back to Horizon real quick.
Yes.
I really think that you would like the combat system because it lends itself to combos.
Okay.
In a Mortal Kombat sense. So it's not like Horde Soaker Turn or anything like that. It's just like button sequences
mm-hmm.
that I think you'd really like.
That's cool. I've also heard that it has Zelda elements. Like, it's a big blue thing on this one, so shoot that part, and then it'll shoot off. So.
You can, like, scan enemies and find their weaknesses, and then mm-hmm. they start glowing.
I like that thing.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely like that. Horizon will happen sometime in the future for me, but I gotta choose. All right, so...
I would wait for it to go on sale.
Yeah, it'll drop to 40 or something soon. But, here's my dilemma. I'm going to throw this out there.
It is a must-buy, but not, like, a must-buy right now.
Yeah. I got Night in the Woods. I got other things. Overwatch. I don't want to play Overwatch anymore. I checked my total Overwatch playtime.
On.
Yeah. I got Gold Pharah.
I just don't care. Like, I just don't care anymore.
Yeah, I mean, it's tough to get back into it after you just, you know. But, so no, my realization was that I checked my total hours played,
Oof.
And it was, like, like 350 plus or something like that. I'm like, I'm going to take a break from Overwatch for a while.
Wasn't Petal at like a week or like something?
Something much more.
Absurd amount of time.
Some crazy things. That was definitely a highlight of 2016. But 2017, I'm trying to put a serious conscious effort
into trying. Oh, that's another thing on the trying. Website. We've put up a list of games that we've started and or finished on thenodcast.com.
Yeah. I misunderstood what you meant by that, because I was okay. Putting up like Hotline stuff, but
I was trying to go like if you replayed it, mm-hmm. to put it on there, just like designate it to replay.
Yeah, because I'm replaying Hotline right now.
Because I've intentionally been trying to play new games. Like I haven't replayed anything in a while.
I think all I've done is replayed things
like, so like just... outside of Night in the Woods, but like just a second playthrough.
Okay, I'll give you the top three games on my PS4 right now that I've been playing. And they're all replays. Mm-hmm. Final Fantasy X-X-2 Remaster. The one I just said before then. God.
Hotline.
There we go. Hotline Miami, 1. And, it feels so good to be back. Because 2 was fun. Like, I enjoyed playing it. But, like,
it's not... I don't get how you're playing on a PlayStation. Like, I don't get how you're, like, not...
Because I'm really good with the claw grip.
I just don't get it. Like, that's such a mouse and keyboard game to me.
That's fair. I mean, that stick works fine.
Yeah.
You haven't seen me play. Getting them A pluses, that S rank. And I'm also, I just had a, the other night, I was like, tomorrow, I'm going to wake up super early before class, and I'm just going to play Metal Gear Solid 5. So I redownloaded it, got started back at like the early mission, like the honeybee, mm-hmm. where they chase you down. Yeah. And like, I forgot how much I love that game. So all of the games I'm playing are just things that I've already played.
That's it. Like, I really want to replay that game. But I know that I will just, like, lose 60 hours.
Will you, though? Because I feel like it's so hard to get... I downloaded it and deleted it and downloaded it and deleted it, like, 3 times before I finally got back.
See, I have it on my PC, so it's just there. It's just there.
Fair. But, like, getting back into it is rough. Because you're like, I totally forgot I have to staff manage and all this stuff. And
it's so good.
Yes. I'm not quite yet, but we're almost there. I just want to finish it, because I never got to the end. I made it to Africa and then stopped, so I think it's been worth it. So yeah, game-wise, just playing everything that I've already played.
Yeah, it's such a strange ending, like, because it's so clear it's not finished.
Yeah, they just cut it off.
But it is worth playing to the end.
Definitely. I just want to see who the arm dude is.
Psycho Mantis, right?
Spoiler, I don't know.
I thought it was.
It looks like him, but no, I don't think he's... I think Psycho Mantis is dead as hell. Oh, wait, prequel. Yeah.
I think it's Psycho Mantis.
I don't know. Metal Gear lore. I'm not going to pretend that I know Metal Gear lore. Psycho Mantis!
Did you ever see that video? It's like Metal Gear lore in like 5 minutes. Like halfway through, like, yeah, this is actually how this goes down.
Then,
like, I'm sorry.
Then Old Snake dies, but then it's so, like, he comes back as a
boss
robot.
Kills big boss, but big boss kills bigger boss. And biggest boss comes out of fucking nowhere. And it's like, hey.
Biggest boss. That was good. That was good. So biggest boss.
This is why we're going to get a studio.
That's why we're going to get a studio, folks. All that we're going to have there are like tiny dog interruptions, maybe. Which would be pleasant, if anything. Who knows? No. So, other things in 2017 that I'm trying to do more. La La Land. Saw it twice. And it inspired me to go to more movies. Because I went to... Civil War. We talked about this on the 2016 wrap up.
I didn't go to anything.
Civil War and like one other. I don't know what it was, but like, I think it was with you.
I was talking about this the other day. This is legitimately every movie stub from 7th grade until now.
You want to go through these?
Not really. But this is legitimately
every... Wait, let me pick out one. Let me just pick one. Wait, are they in order? I don't want to mess up the order.
No, they're not in order.
Okay. Let me get the...
Every movie set, including the 3 that I just went to.
A Dangerous Method?
Yeah, it's about Sigmund Freud or something like that.
Okay. I'll get one more.
Keep going.
All right. Cult classic Aki?
Oh, it was Akira.
Oh, Akira was shown in Majestic?
They were doing like cult classics. So like every Saturday at midnight, they would have a cult classic film for like $5. Or whatever the amount of money is.
Gotcha. Big Short.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
Very good editing.
I saw that on demand. All right, last one.
But yeah, so
make it magic. This one over here looks good.
I go to
where are these from?
AMC.
Nice. Star Trek.
That's, yeah, it's the like original reboot.
Nice. From like 2009.
Yes.
Ooh.
Like I wasn't kidding when I said like this is from.
Yeah.
2009. I think 2000. I have some from like 2008 in here, in 2007.
Ah, I wish I could take the part of my
2008 memory. Pineapple Express, 2008.
Nice. I wish I could take the part of my memory that remembers what year Star Trek came out, that movie, and like, you know, learn something else.
Leatherheads. I liked it. It's action. It's not anything like spectacular. Yeah, but no, I really liked it.
No, I'm not hating on the movie. I'm just saying that I'm just upset that I know the year that the movie I didn't actually see came out.
Oh, that is entirely your fault.
Yeah, I don't know how that happened. What else we got?
So no, it's 2017 inspired you to have more movies?
Yeah, La La Land was like the
which
best
is like
thing
the
ever.
Love letter to Hollywood.
It was so like, and then they're walking through the sets mm-hmm. and stuff. It's so yeah, La La Land. All right, we could just go on about that.
I'm
but
so salty about what happened at the Oscars.
That was
cool. I think I really do believe that La La Land is a better film than Moonlight. I think Moonlight's a very important film and a very good film, but I think La La Land was a better film.
It would have. You just can't do that.
You just can't mess up. You really can't.
That was just such as
that's crushing.
And the guy was like, "I don't mind giving this to Moonlight. My friends over at Moonlight." He said that. And he was
that's crushing.
But like, you know that on the inside, he was just like,
"See, like he seemed upset, but not like because he lost, but because that he lost that way."
Yeah, that's terrible. But yeah, no. But in defense of Moonlight, or sorry, not that we were hating on it, but La La Land were like six other things.
Yeah.
So, but Best Picture is, you know.
See, what's weird to me is when Best Actress, Best Song, mm-hmm. Best.
What does Best Song even mean, though? Because the whole thing is that what it means? Are you talking singular?
No, so it was nominated for two songs. So for City of Stars and Fools Who Dream.
Really? Fools Who Dream? Mm-hmm. The epilogue? Mm-hmm. Or not the epilogue, but the audition?
Yes.
Okay. I thought that someone in the crowd would be there.
Someone in the crowd will be the one to take you home. God, it's such a good movie.
But no.
Such a good soundtrack.
Yes. No, so I had taken my mother, because she enjoys the musicals, and she, you know, she goes to way less movies than even me, you know. She'll watch at home or whatever, but so I took my mom, she loves musicals, and I could just tell that I got her. I got her on this one,
so
folks.
Good.
And yeah. So not only did this like re-energize my desire to go see movies, but it also re-energized, I think, everyone's desire for good musicals.
Yeah.
Because this thing...
I remember talking about it to you in the summer when the trailer came out, mm-hmm. and I was losing my shit.
Yeah, I didn't care at all then.
You didn't care at all, but I was like losing my shit because that trailer was and is perfect.
And in the trailer, it's the scene where he walks in and kisses her.
The best trailer possibly ever.
Was that the one set to Jesus? That's
the City of Stars.
It's set to City of Stars. He walks in and kisses her. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. 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 I did not give a damn back then. And you called it. You called it from a mile away. So.
Yes. Two, like, I remember being in your room and I showed you the trailer and I'm like, how do you not fuck it? There's everything. This and this and this and there's this and it's just great. And the song and the things. And you're just like, please leave.
I don't think I said that. That's,
the look in your eyes was just like, I need you out of my home right now.
I don't remember being that harsh at all, but yeah, I wasn't.
Your eyes.
But see, I'm not. I wasn't in the know on Gosling or Emma Stone because I didn't see.
They're so attractive.
Emma Stone is.
Both of them are just like, just look at me, but don't look at me because I'm afraid that like I'll turn to stone.
Wait, Emma Stone. Okay, I was listening to a podcast the other day, and Emma Stone. They were talking about Emma Stone was in a superhero movie, but it was Spider-Man, Amazing Spider-Man.
Yeah, she was Gwen Stacy.
Okay, is that? Should I go back and do that? The Shocker
no.
one. Oh, no, no,
no.
I heard one was good, but two was...
One was good, two jumped the gun.
Homecoming. Homecoming.
Homecoming should be good.
Homecoming. Should be good.
It should be.
It's going to be good. They can't fuck that up.
Okay, here's... This is
high school
timeline. This is my official prediction. It will be good, not great.
Ooh, well, that's even worse.
No, I don't think so, because like it's going to be Marvel good, not Marvel
okay,
great.
Okay, not DC good, which is 3 out of 10.
Low-hanging... Academy Award winner. Suicide Squad.
Ooh. Wait, oh.
Doesn't that hurt? Doesn't that hurt your feelings, like, a lot?
Wait, what book for
makeup?
Okay.
Makeup over Star Trek.
I don't know. So wait, well, the new
Star Trek Beyond.
Yeah. How was that like on? Was that on point? Was that makeup?
It was. They had literal armies of aliens and cities not populated CG? Of yeah. And like they were showing like the behind the scenes stuff, and like it's, I don't know why they chose the scenes that they chose, mm-hmm. but like. It just clearly showed so much more technical ability in Star Trek than they showed in like the clips for Suicide Squad. Mm. But
Academy Award.
I want, like, I really want to be a part of the Academy so that way, like, I at least have a vote.
So you can just be like, "Fuck you, Suicide Squad! You're not gonna win."
This. I really do want to be a part of the Academy at some point, just because like I want to vote and I want to be a part of that process.
So if the Academy's watching, your boy. Your boy, hire him. He can do the sound.
I watch so many movies. It's almost sad.
He's watched at least 6 movies in his lifetime.
Like, yeah.
It's this many.
At least 6.
All right, let's grab one more.
All right. And I remember a lot of these, too, which is weird. Where's that one?
Green Lantern. Is this the Ryan Reynolds one?
Yeah. Oh. I think this was from... Was this AMC? Oh, it's Indian River. There's a couple from, like, Jersey.
Wait, so maybe DC movies were always bad. If the Ryan Reynolds Green Lantern, I forgot about that movie.
Like, I have a couple of, like, the MoMA tickets and stuff that.
What year did the Ryan Reynolds one come out?
Oh, I don't know. I put the ticket away. Dang it.
Because they've been bad since then.
Yeah. Is this it? No. This is the Wolverine. The one where he goes to Japan.
What?
Yeah, he goes to Japan.
Oh, it's called The Wolverine?
Yeah.
Okay.
That was really bad.
Why does he go to Japan?
I don't remember.
What's he doing there?
Yeah, I don't remember. Despicable Me, Wall-E, I Love You, Man.
I thought we were only going to do the one. I don't know why you're...
Little Fockers. Jesus. That was a good movie. I've seen a lot of bad movies, too.
Little Fockers was good.
Bedtime Stories, Monsters vs. Aliens. I saw that in 3D. Why?
Monsters vs. Aliens?
I can't read this one. Oh, Brave. Some of them got faded like the hell. Amazing Spider-Man.
There we go.
Speak of the Devil. Another Jamie amazing Fox. Spider-Man.
Jamie Foxx.
Wreck-It Ralph. Skyfall. The Avengers. I saw the Avengers like 6 times, and I don't think I have all of their... all the tickets from the Avengers.
All in the same theater?
No.
No, you went IMAX and stuff too,
right? No, that was Avengers 2.
Gotcha. Oh.
Oh, well.
Yeah, Age of Mediocre.
It wasn't... It was okay.
I'm just kidding.
It was Marvel.
I liked it a lot.
Oh, my Daily Show's ticket stub.
Damn.
Went to taping.
When'd you go?
October 1st, 2014.
Cool.
October 1st, 2014. This is The Daily Show with Jon Stewart.
Now. What was I going to say?
So Switch.
Switch. We're just never going to talk about Switch. No. So the reason I'm talking about the movie interest and everything is because we never really did a resolution episode. So
that's true.
My other resolution was to read more. And what this manifested into was... I mean, I read a lot of like articles, whatever, stuff like that online, but I wanted to do physical stuff. Mm-hmm. And so instead of doing like the normal thing and just getting like a bunch of books or something, I just bought a bunch of manga and comics.
That's fair.
So you gave me Kingdom Come for Christmas.
Yes, it did.
So I've been getting through Kingdom Come. It's insanity. I don't even know what's happening. Like,
great.
I don't know enough about DC.
Oh, it's
to,
so good.
So when they're like, Booster Gold isn't here. I'm like,
Booster Gold kind of sucks.
Okay. But you know what I mean? Like
Booster Gold is the Nova of...
I love Nova. He's my main in Ultimate Marvel's Cap.
So, yeah. It's the same guy.
Okay.
Pretty much.
Okay. I love Booster Gold.
I think he can time travel or something like that.
What?
I don't...
That's not Nova.
Maybe I'm thinking of someone else.
All right. Was the dude from Talladega Nights Nova in Guardians of the Galaxy?
Yes.
Okay.
No,
yeah,
no.
He looks just like him.
He wasn't Nova. He was part of the Nova Corps.
Oh, wait. So then who's Nova?
Nova's like the guy... Who started the Nova Corps? Something along
those lines. All right, fuck comics. I'm done with this shit. No, so I got that, and then I'm reading comics in a very weird way, because I just read... I'm not reading them through. I'm reading whatever I want to read at that time.
Yeah.
Which is odd, because it's like, oh, tonight I want to read Batman. And the way that this works now is that I have a lamp by my... I have a lamp set up by my bed. So mm-hmm. 30 minutes before bed, open it, boom, get through. And so I'm also working my way through Court of Owls. But okay. I think I just need to... commit to one instead of doing this flip-flop.
So yeah, like I have the opposite problem. Like if I start a book or if I start a comic or if I start some form of media, I have to finish it before I start anything else. But the thing is, like, I don't finish it, so I just don't start anything else.
That's bad.
Yeah.
That's
really bad. And it, like, certain things, like Goodnight Pun Pun, Tomei, and things like mangas. I ran through, and I, like, they're very much like stories. Like, I was reading them, and, like, I know I'm never gonna think the same way after these, which is nice. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, it kind of like set the bar too high for other mangas. So, like, I was reading Princess Knight behind me, and it's good, and it's Tezuka. It's good, but I've also read other Tezuka that's just much better. So I'm just like,
ooh,
I just don't want to read this anymore. So just sitting there.
Fair enough. I was gonna say
resolutions.
Yeah, no, but specifically Stolen Comics. Oh, I sent you a Snapchat and you never responded, and I was very upset. I had Goodnight Pun Pun 1 in my hand, and then in the other hand was like some terrible slice of life bullshit, and I was like, which one do I get? And you never responded, so I ended up getting like Cardcaptor Sakura or something else.
Okay, where did that third option come from?
That's what it was, is that I put down both of them and just picked up Cardcaptor Sakura. It's an omnibus though, so I got all of that.
Fair enough.
It's pretty cool.
Fair enough.
Windy. But no, I'm enjoying it just because it's nice to take 30 minutes and I don't play music. Like, normally I have some sort of music or something happening while I'm in my workspace.
I can't do that.
But
like, I can't listen to music. Actually, finish your thought, because I want to.
Yeah.
I want to. This topic is resolutions. We're talking about resolutions.
I think that I abuse audio too much. Like, I have to have something. I'll have podcasts on like just all day. Mm-hmm. Like, I need to have something.
On. No, you're talking about earlier. You said you just need white noise.
Not just white noise, but
and I'm like, I'm the total opposite. I'm just like,
yeah, complete silence. No. So I just need to have something stimulating to listen to, and it's a problem, I think. So this comic and reading time at the end of the night or towards the end of the night has really helped me, because there's nothing else on. I'm just reading.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really nice just to be like that silence.
I can dig it. I feel that in a lot of ways.
Yeah, I just feel like I fill my days too much with audio.
I don't remember if I was talking to you about this or if I was talking to Kat about this, but like the whole, I'm very much a fan of New Year's resolutions. I never keep New Year's resolutions, but I always try, which I think is a good thing.
I went to a gym in January. Never signed up. They weren't looking too good.
Just walked in.
It was 30 down, 30 a month.
You walked in and immediately walked out.
Yeah. 30 down, 30 a month is not bad, though. I mean, they have a treadmill. It's that really depressing one over by the mall. But it's open 24/7, because I'm the type of person that would be like, it's 4 a.m.
Time to
go for a run. I told them I would only use the elliptical. That's why I want to go. Also, I found an elliptical for $200 at Play It Again Sports.
Jesus.
Should I go for it?
Maybe. Have you seen that Vine, kind of funny Vine?
Which one?
Colin on the
elliptical?
Yeah.
No. Oh, my God.
I'll have to send it to you later. It's so funny.
I love his elliptical.
It's not kind of funny. It's Greg Miller specifically.
Gotcha.
But I can't remember if I was talking to you or if I was talking to Kat about it. But, like, I am very much a New Year's resolution person. I said this. I don't keep them very well, but I try.
Sure.
And I've been keeping this one pretty well.
No meth?
Yeah. I've been meth-free since literally ever.
Good for you.
Keeping that streak alive.
Good to hear.
But last year, I found myself, like, obviously I was busier. So I was still trying to fit in all of the things that I like to do, but in with less time. And I found myself doing too many things at one time and not getting the effect of just one thing. So like I would be watching a movie and I'd be on my computer. I'd be reading a book and listening to music. And like,
you're not getting the full,
I'm getting like half experiences from entire things.
I definitely vibe with that, with the listening to a podcast while playing a game.
And the only thing that like I did full on was like when I was driving to and from class, because I had that hour and a half commute. Mm-hmm. I was listening to podcasts, so like that was something that I was invested in. So I would be listening to podcasts and be really listening
you're stuck
to, because I'm in the car for an hour and a half, and that was the only thing that I felt like I was really only focused on. So this year I've been doing things specifically to just focus in on one thing. So if I, like, if I know that I want to watch a movie, or if I say, like, I'm going to watch a movie, I will intentionally turn off my computer and put my phone either, like, on my desk or plug it in or something like that. So that I'm not tempted to...
It's so easy.
Yeah.
It's
so it really easy. Is. It really is.
It's so easy.
And, like, so I bought a record player because I really... Like, I am a huge fan of jazz, and I just wanted to... Like, because I use my phone and my computer primarily for music because of Spotify. And I just really wanted to pick up albums that I'm very fond of, or albums that I've been meaning to listen to for a while because they are so revered. It's like Kind of Blue.
Mm-hmm.
It's this classic quintessential Miles Davis one. I've listened to that probably like 10 times.
Is that the one with flamenco on sketches and all that?
I think so.
Flamenco sketches and... God, I used to have it, but...
Like, I've listened to it on Spotify a couple times, but, like, I haven't really, like, listened to it. I've always been doing something else and just been background noise. So, like, I bought that album, put it on my record player, turned off my computer, turned on my sound system, and, like, I was literally just on my floor for the duration of the album. Just, like, lying down, headphones on, just...
Oh, you could plug headphones into that?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. That's interesting. I thought... See, when you said that you were going to need a record player, I thought you had the old Vox phone.
Controller. No. But, like, I've been going out of my way, and I've been setting up things... So, like, I hung my trumpets up on the wall because they've been sitting in a case for a year. And now I have the ability to literally just... And play.
Yeah.
And, like, I'm very much a person out of sight, out of mind.
Mm-hmm.
So...
Oh, definitely.
Like, you can see in my room, everything is out. Everything's out. Like, there are very few things in drawers. Like, the only thing that I put in drawers are things that I don't need or need to, like, literally just hide because it just looks like clutter.
Clothes?
So, like, I took the closet doors off my closet because they're bugging me.
That didn't always strike me as odd.
Yeah. I could put up a curtain, but I don't want to.
Your closet's fully loaded, though.
Yes, so. It is. And then, like...
This is a shitty resolution. What is this?
To be more present.
Oh, okay. Okay, yeah. I thought it was to organize your closet more.
Yeah, I should really get into my closet. And I realized how quiet I sounded because I was sitting so far away from the mic.
It's probably been the whole show.
No, I'll boost it later because...
Booster gold.
I'm kind of low on my volume anyway. So here's some dulcet tones for your ears. Afternoon. It's been a while. Have you been? I've been okay. We didn't really talk about anything today. We just kind of rambled.
Switch over to this topic. So what? Whoa! Are we? I thought we had. Oh, yo! If we just had 1-2 switch set up, and suddenly we were playing.
Ping. I'm so mad. Greg, I want it tonight.
Yeah, you can't play it tonight. I should go get Zelda just to spite you. Play it on the Wii U. Look at the 480p. It's so.
I don't think that's out tonight.
What?
I don't think they're releasing the Wii U thing tonight. I think they're.
I thought there was like a bundle though.
No. I don't think they're doing the Zelda Wii U until the 3rd.
Wait, what?
Mm.
That's bullshit.
Haha. Mustard race.
I have a...
No, Switch Mustard Race. Excuse you.
That was the best, like,
that's
Nintendo
a great sound effect
I've ever seen.
It's a very good sound effect.
The controller's moving. Oh, wait, okay. Actually, let's talk about Switch now.
Yeah, let's close out with the
Switch.
Are
you nervous about this left controller desync issue? Have you read about this?
Yes, I have. Apparently, the only people it affected were, like... The people who got it substantially earlier than everyone else.
So review people.
No. I mean, like,
people are IGN gave it like oh my god, it's like 6 or 7 because of that. Like that was one of the main reasons. No, sorry, not entirely because of that, but you know.
I don't know. I think people are very willing to jump the gun on this because it is new hardware.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not the first time new hardware has been finicky.
Okay. Yeah.
And sure. I think they're being extra critical because it is Nintendo following the Wii U.
Sure.
And it isn't a home run in the sense that it's this groundbreaking. It is very innovative, but it's not. It's still Nintendo. So I think they're reviewing it with caution.
Okay.
And they're reviewing it like cautiously and with like a little bit higher hopes than they needed. Because like
that makes sense. But what I heard is that if you were sitting here, mm-hmm. TV is obviously there, and the sensor's over there. When you, like, if my body was blocking it in any way,
It is IR, isn't it?
If my body was blocking in any way, I heard yelling, I was like, what? If my body was blocking in any way, then yeah, it wouldn't go through, which is like, so it's not just bodies. Like, it could be this table or anything. Like, I just don't, I want to see it when you get yours. I want to see if it's,
tomorrow night.
It's either going to be a complete non-issue and work fine, or everyone's screwed and you have to get like some software update or something crazy, or I don't even know what would happen.
I don't think it's going to be a problem for longer than a day. I don't think it's going to be like this massive.
If it's a controller issue, hardware issue.
I don't think it's a hardware issue. I think it's a firmware issue.
Okay.
Because you can change, like with the digital mics, they have a input delay as opposed to the analog mics. So like when we were running the Snowball and the Bay Bottle, when we were doing the Gungeon races, because of that sync, we had that echo. Mm-hmm. But I can tune it so that sync falls in line with the analog. So I just have to put on a delay. So like you can tune signals like that.
Mm-hmm. It might just take some updates on there.
I really don't think it's going to be an issue. So far from what I've heard from more independent reviewers and not big things, that they have not had an issue with it. And it doesn't seem to be
as frequent as
IGN and Polygon or was it GameSpot?
Oh, you're saying even tinier than... I mean, Polygon's big, but not, you know, big.
It doesn't seem to be a very common thing between people that I have seen, and that's anecdotal. Okay.
Yeah, sure. No, I'm not saying that it's a deal-breaker by any means. It's just that everyone was like, this thing is awesome. This is the most... I've heard that this is, like, the best quality build Nintendo's done. The screen is fucking gorgeous.
God, I'm so mad at Best
Buy. And I'm just looking at my Wii U screen like...
480p. God, I love 2009.
Hey, but they did give me Wii Sports Resort for free or something like that. I don't know. I logged back into my Wii U for the first time in months and it was like, you got a free game. Switch.
All right, so, you know, let's wrap it up real quick. We talked about a bunch of things.
What launch titles do you want to get?
I've already pre-ordered Breath of the Wild. Okay. So I'm certainly getting Breath of the Wild. And I got my 128 gig SD card, so I'm ready for whatever the Switch can throw at me.
I've got a 2 gig one if you want.
No, thank you.
Maybe store like snipper clippers.
I think snipper clips is more than that. I'm not really interested in snipper clips. It looks cool, but like it's not something I would like.
What actively play?
Breath of the Wild and 1-2 Switch are the two that I'm certainly
getting. The Blastmaster remake.
I don't care about Blaster Master.
What?
It's a Mega Man knockoff to me.
What the fuck? It's not, though. It's different. I thought it came... No, I thought it was around that same time period. Mm. Maybe even before.
No.
Okay.
Well...
Okay. Well, no, wait. Last thing on Switch. They did announce a bunch of indies.
Yes, they had the whole indie...
Let me pull this up.
They had 60 independent titles announced yesterday. Or something like over 60. Granted, some of them are ones that we've seen before, so Shovel Knight, Spectre of Torment. They announced one that looked really interesting to me, Flipping Death or something like that.
It was a big...
That looked really cool. Like, the art style wasn't for me, and that's kind of throwing me off, because, like, has an art... I don't want to get into that. That's a topic for later today, but, like, the art style on it is kind of bugging me, so, like, I don't want to play it, but, like, the mechanics seem cool, so I want to play it. But a lot of the indie games that I saw yesterday, they weren't anything really new or really exciting, so it kind of sucked.
Gotcha. Oh, Stardew Valley's getting there, too.
I don't care about it.
Hold on. Here's the list. Oh, also, my buddy went to GDC, and he was telling me all about the panels, and some of the VR ones were insane, but the cool one was he talked to the Hyper Light guys.
Oh, Heart Machine?
I had to sit down with them, yeah. Nice. He said they were still burnt out.
They're still burnt out. They came out a year ago. Holy shit. They came out last April.
Wow.
Right?
Ukulele.
Yeah.
Confirmed for Switch. Just if there's anything else on here that you wanted to mention. Isaac, Afterbirth is worth mentioning.
Afterbirth is worth mentioning.
That's good.
I think Runner 3, The Trip Runner, is worth mentioning.
Celeste, that one with the mountain down there next to Stardew. Yeah. I've seen good things about that, or heard good things about that. But like, so I was talking shit. Your boy Dan C was talking shit. I was like, the Switch library looks kind of bad. The launch library, at least. But then this came out, and I was like, oh, this plus Zelda is like everything that I could possibly need.
Yeah, I think that the Nintendo is going to be a great indie machine. I think it's going to be a better indie machine than Sony at the moment.
Runner 3 too.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
World of Goo for some reason. It's like a mobile port.
World of Goo was PC.
I played World of Goo on iPad though, I think.
Did you?
Yeah.
Okay.
My mom had an iPad back in 07. I don't know what year World of Goo came out. 2011 maybe, 2012. Who knows? Switch to the end of the show. Next time you see us, folks, we will not be in Matthew's room. We will be in Matthew's other room.
Yeah, probably. It'll probably be set up next week.
Oh, yeah, wait, maybe it's not.
No, it'll be set up next week.
Okay.
I have a couple days off next week, so.
If you don't, we may be back in here, but no.
The next time you see us, we'll be in.
Vanoss.
Well,
that's the next
time.
Night Owl
studio. Next time we do a Nogcast, it'll be.
There we go. Yeah. If we need to do other things, we can.
If we need to do other things, we'll do other things. But thank you once again for tuning in. Ladies and gentlemen, as always, I have been your lovely host, Matthew. And this dashing...
Got no water left.
Guy to my right.
Now, you kind of paused there right before you said guy. Like,
I was trying to think of a D word that wasn't dude.
Dashing douche.
Dashing dude, dashing douche. All right, we'll go with that one.
Dashing douche?
This dashing douche to my right.
Wow.
Is Dan.
Wait, like, is the douche dashing or... Good night or good morrow.